Guys, how we doing? Welcome to Good Works Tractors. You can see behind me 7 different tractors. They're all a different size. It's the first time maybe ever that I've had basically every possible frame size of John Deere compacts or subcompacts available. And it's just for a small window of time as 3 of these tractors are sold. So no time like the present. Let's give you a side-by-side comparison of all 7 of these models here. That way you can see, physically see the frame size differences. Just a brief overview so you kind of have a better feel when you're tractor shopping. Not only that, but we're gonna answer the age-old question of aluminum versus steel rear ends. I've got some magnets right here. We're just gonna go ahead and stick them on the rear ends. If they stick, it's a steel transaxle, but if they don't, it's an aluminum rear end. It's hard to find that answer online, so this little trick right here should let us all know. So if you end up enjoying this video, I'd love to get a thumbs up from you. There's a subscribe button right next to it as well. If you haven't done so yet, I'd encourage you to do so and read through that description right underneath the video if you're in the market for a tractor or a cool tractor attachment. Okay, we have these set up from smallest to largest. Again, subcompacts and compacts only. That's all we're talking about here. Our examples today, we have a 2018 John Deere 1025R, a 2018 John Deere 2025R, 2017 John Deere 2032R, right here a 2019 3032E. Now this one's a bit of an anomaly, okay? We have a John Deere 3520 representing our 3R series, like the 3033R, 3039, 3046R. Basically the same exact thing, a few just different modifications to it. Another one right here, the John Deere 4105, kind of in between the 3 and the 4 series, and flanking on the end over here, a 4066R. Let's start off with a few general notes to kind of help you visualize what these machines are for. You know, starting on the smaller end, anything down here in this half can have a belly mower on it, okay? And so that's gonna be typically one of the primary functions that you're gonna want to accomplish with your tractor is mowing your lawn. So you get a mower on here, you can take them off with the auto connects on John Deere, but same thing applies to a Kubota, Mahindra, Coyote, LS, all the other manufacturers. One of the primary functions will be mowing your lawn, okay? You can add on the front end loaders, you can add on a backhoe. They're all gonna have 3-point hitches and rear PTO, so you can put brush hogs and tillers, box blades, land levelers, all sorts of attachments on the 3-point as well. But as you start to work your way further and further up the food chain, some of these models won't even come with a belly mower option, starting with the 3E series of tractor. No mid PTO, which is the power takeoff that's in the middle of the tractor, which will operate a belly mower. You can't get that on the 3E. Once you get to a 3R or a 3X20 series, what you see represented right here, you can potentially get a belly mower on there. I don't really think it's very conducive to mowing a regular homeowner's property. If you have large swaths of land, you can get up to a 72-inch wide mower on something like this machine right here. But once you get up to the 4105 or a 4M or a 4R series tractor, a belly mower is not even going to be an option. So really starting with the 3E, 3R series on upward, your focus is more on using the front end loader, the 3-point hitch, maybe the backhoe, not really mowing at all. That's kind of ruled out or is very minimal, or you're going to find a way to put a 3-point finish mower on there. But these are going to have a lot more lift capacity, stability, run bigger attachments as well, and they're also going to weigh a lot more, so a lot bigger footprint where navigating in a lawn is not going to be very conducive. So these are going to be more for larger acreage properties, whether it's a 5-acre woodlot or a 40-acre or maybe a 200-acre property that you have. I know everybody always wants price points. I'll go ahead and give you these price points. Just keep in mind, they're going to change with time, with the amount of hours, with the options. There's a lot of variables. So what you see here does not mean that's what you can buy one of these tractors for in your area or in the future. I sell used tractors. Nothing you see here is new. So the 1025R, it's 2018, about 170 hours with a front end loader, a belly mower, the backhoe, the Summit hydraulic kit on here. Say it has the dual tires as well. I'd sell it for $20,000 to $21,000. A 2018 2025R with the front end loader and a belly mower on it, about 165, 170 hours. Again, gonna be around $19,000. Next one up, a 2017 John Deere 2032R. This is the redesigned generation. There is a generation 1, I guess, 2032R, that's gonna be cheaper. So this is the redesigned version, about 320 hours, I think, on there. Only the loader, no belly mower on this one, $20,000. 2019 John Deere 3032E, this one had a brand new loader put on it, only about 45 or 50 hours, $20,000 for this one. Now this is going to be the oldest one in the bunch here, the John Deere 3520, again equivalent to a 3R series tractor today, most similar to the 3039R, but 850 hours, front end loader, third function, wheel weights. It's loaded up pretty well, but it is a 2006, $22,000 for this one. This is a bit of an anomaly, kind of a 3.5 series. The front end loader is actually the same loader that's found on the 3R or the 3X20 series. Same tires though that are found on the 4 series. It's a little bit narrower, a little bit lighter. It's kind of in a class of its own, but the John Deere 4105, this is a 2016 model year. Equipped with the backhoe and the front end loader. Can't get a belly mower on here, but what's this one have? I think it's about 200 hours, $33,000. Now this one here is my baby. Okay, I've decked this thing out almost to the max. There's a few things I could still tweak, but the 4066R is kind of the creme de la creme of compact tractors with the factory cab, all sorts of hydraulic remotes. I've done a lot of videos on this one. They're not all gonna be equipped like this. If I were to sell this, I think it's got about 320 hours, a 2016 model year. So the price for this one right here, never mind, this one's priceless. I'm just joking, but if I were to sell it, I'm not though. I already made that mistake once, so check out that video up above. If I were to sell it, it'd probably be somewhere around the 45 or maybe into the high 40,000s, not quite to the $50,000 mark with the way it's set up here. So my own two machines are on the outside, the 1025R and the 4066R. I have them for a couple of reasons. One, I want to be able to demonstrate a lot of different attachments and variety of applications on a couple of the more popular models. You know, the 1025R is probably the most popular subcompact tractor that's on the market, maybe even if you encompassed all compact tractors as well. On the opposite end of the spectrum, the 4066R is the biggest of the 4 series, or the Grand L, that really large frame size in the compact world, running the largest attachments you can get, both on the front and the back. You know, it's funny when you see all these sitting side by side, I mean, they almost barely go up in size just physically looking at them. So it's kind of deceiving, I'm sure, you know, when you're watching it on TV or on the computer screen as well. But pay attention to all those specs online. You know, this is a very brief overview because it's just a ton of information otherwise. So I'm giving you just kind of the big hitters, but look at the base weights of the tractors, look at the front end loaders, their lift capacities, their lift heights, maybe the same thing on the 3-point hitch, your width of the tractors as well. You know, if you have certain requirements that you need to get done, I always use the example of lifting a round bale of hay, something that weighs 800 pounds. There's just certain tractors that cannot lift that kind of weight. But if you don't have specific requirements, then you can size any attachment pretty much for the tractor. You know, they make a grapple that fits a small 1025R, they make a grapple that fits a 4066R. Same thing for any attachment going on the back or the front of the tractors. So don't worry about the size of the tractor so much unless you have specific tasks or maybe a large acreage application where using a small tractor just isn't gonna get the job done fast enough for you. Let's compare the 1025R and the 2025R, a true 1 series and what I call a 1.5 series. The 2025R, while it's technically a 2 series, is not a full frame 2 series. I like to call it a 1025R HD or a 1.5 series. You're gonna have the same front end loader, a 120R, it's the only option. Same lift capacity on both, same lift height. You will have a little bit different or more 3-point lift capacity on the 2025R. It's gonna be a little bit heavier. It's the same width, slightly longer, sits slightly higher. But it's a very similar machine to the 1025R. You'll see, of course, the tires are larger. One important thing to note, these VersaTurf tires that you can see on my 1025R, also available on the 2025R. Essentially the same engine underneath the hood, a 2-range high-low transmission, they're diesel engines, hydrostatic. A 54 or 60-inch belly mower is an option on either one. They're also going to use the same backhoe as well. Last point to consider, you can put a cab on either one of these machines, but it's going to be an aftermarket cab, not a factory cab, no air conditioning available. Okay, next comparison, 2025R versus a full-frame 2R tractor. This is a 2032. This could also be the 2038. Standing back there, you would never know the difference. A sticker on here, a turbo underneath, same loader, same lift capacity. So 2032, 2038, we're finally stepping up from a 120R loader to a 220R. So you're gonna lift more weight and you're gonna lift it higher as well. So still only one choice of loader. You don't have multiple options. Belly mowers, you can put a belly mower in either one. 54 and 60 on the 2025, 60 or 72-inch on the large frame 2R. We're talking nominal horsepower, 25 horsepower, and then 32 or 38 horsepower on this series here. You can put backhoes on both. This is gonna be the 260B, and then you have the 270B up here on the large frame. A couple other important points, you're gonna move from about 48 inches wide up to about 4.5 foot or 54 inches wide. You're also gonna tack on another 500 or 600 pounds of weight on the large frame 2R over the 2025R. Three other points I wanna mention, you are still gonna have a two-range hydrostatic transmission, high and low range. You can still only get those aftermarket cabs, no factory cab with air conditioning. But one really nice feature that you can get on the large frame 2R, the 2032 and 2038, is called the command cut hydraulic mower deck system, where it's gonna operate independently from your three-point hitch. On the 2025 and the 1025, when you pull that same lever that's gonna raise and lower your three-point hitch, that's also gonna make your mower deck go up and down as well. Oh, one last thing I wanted to mention, obviously tire size is getting larger as well. I've even had some folks, one guy sent me a picture of it, another guy sent me a link to a thread where they took the tires off of the 3E series and actually made them fit and work on the large frame 2R series. First time I'd ever seen that, but you gain a little bit of ground clearance underneath there, and of course a little bit more weight as well for the tractor. Guys are doing crazy things all the time. All right, folks, this is where things really start to get confusing. You have a John Deere 2032R, and this is a 3032E. So they're both 32 horsepower tractors, technically a 3 series, while this is a 2 series. But you stare at them side by side, and they look, you know, just about identical, don't they? Of course, this one does have ag tires on it, which typically are going to allow a tractor to sit up even a little bit higher. But there's gonna be some other big differences. Now, I want you to know that on pretty much all the models you see here, I've done really in-depth, in-detail comparison. So the 2R versus the 3E, just for an example, but the 1 and the 2 series, the 3 and the 4, on down the line. So take a look through all those videos I have if you wanna get a really in-depth look at the similarities and the differences between models and series. So the 2R, anything that ends with an R in the John Deere lineup is gonna be a deluxe or a premium series. That's kind of a way to think about it. The E series, like the 3032E, also the 3025 and the 3038E, are gonna be an economy series. I don't know if that's what the E actually stands for, but that's the easiest way to think about it. They're plain Jane, kind of more of a throwback tractor without a lot of bells and whistles on it, whereas something like the 2032R or the first couple of models, the 1025 and the 2025, are kind of decked out with all the options that you might ever want. Front end loaders, again, you're only gonna have one available model to choose from. There's not multiple loader models you can get. Quick attach buckets are standard on everything you see here, but this entire loader on the 2R series can come off. The 3E series is one of the only series with maybe one or two other exceptions where the loader doesn't actually, it's not a quick park loader. You know, you'd have to go through a whole unbolting process. There's no quick couplers for the hydraulics, but the bucket can still be removed. You can put pallet forks on, snow pusher, any other attachments that would go up front. You cannot put a mower deck on a 3E series. It's just not possible. There's not a mid PTO option on this series of tractors, so you can't do it. If you're looking to run a belly mower, you have to rule this machine out. As you know, you can put the 60 or 72 inch deck on the 2R series. And something I didn't mention before, because they all had them so far, but the seats, there's not really gonna be any kind of a suspension on the 3E series tractor. It's kind of a rough ride, so to speak, where there's a nice suspension seat on all of the previous models we've talked about. And they also have armrests here, which are a really nice add-on. So while you're gonna miss other convenience features on the 3E series, such as tilt steering or cruise control, that's what's gonna help bring that price down and make it a little bit more economical for folks. So you do have the R4 tread pattern, just like what you see on the 2R. You can also get those, of course, on the 3E. You can get turfs on pretty much all of these as well if you want to. You are gonna have about a 60 inch wide tractor versus 54, so you're getting wider, maybe a touch longer, but the weight of these machines and a lot of these other specs with lift capacities really start to overlap a lot. So the decisions you wanna make are gonna revolve around price point, if you need a belly mower. Now you can put a backhoe on either one of these machines. There's an earlier generation, take note, an earlier generation of the 3E, 2017 and older, that you cannot put a backhoe on. So if you want to get a backhoe on a 3E, make it 2018 or newer. We're still not into any kind of a machine that you can get a factory cab with air. Cabs are available, aftermarket, heat only. Oh yeah, one more thing as well. Two range hydrostatic machines, high and low range, no medium. We're gonna get to that soon though. You know, now we're really starting to get to some significant changes between series. These are both a 3 Series tractor, a 3E, and a 3R. Again, we're representing this with the 3520, which I'm telling you, they're very close to the 3R, just some, basically some layout changes for the most part, but the same loaders, same tires, same wheelbase, same weight, same features you can get on the 3R and the 3X20, so it's representative enough. Comparing this tractor to the 3E is night and day difference. While they look pretty similar when you see them side by side, this loader is going to lift hundreds of pounds more. It's going to weigh hundreds of pounds more, this machine. The tires are going to be pretty similar in size. The wheelbase is going to be pretty similar in size as well, but your 3-point lift capacity is going to dwarf what you can do on the 3E. It's just really a very rugged, well-built machine compared to its lighter duty counterpart, the 3E series. You might be able to tell I'm getting a little excited because I really love this series of tractor. I want to recap what I mentioned previously. This is a 2019 with 43 hours, 32 horsepower for $20,000. This is a 2006 with 850 hours on it. And what did I say? $22,000. So it's 13 years older, a lot more hours on it, but it's still more money than that 3E. I want to reiterate that point for a reason, because it's really so much more tractor, a 3X20, so the 3320, 3520, 3720, or the 3R, any of those, compared to what you get on a 3E tractor. Along with what we've talked about already, you are gonna finally have a 3-range hydrostatic transmission available on this series. You can also get it equipped with a power reverser, so you're starting to see multiple options come into play. Same thing with the front end loader. You're gonna have two different variants of the front end loader, one that will lift a little less or more, and one that'll lift a little higher and a little shorter. So you have a lot of options there. You have a lot of hydraulic options you can add on as well. And guess what? You even have a factory cab option that you can get with air conditioning and heat. So while the weight and the capacity is greatly increased, you're still in a 60-inch wide footprint here for the 3E and the 3R. So you can use a 5-foot wide attachment on these and be just fine, like a box blade or a brush hog or a tiller, anything along those lines. This is just probably the best example of the disparity between different series within the same frame size of a machine, the 3E versus the 3R. A couple final thoughts on the 3R or that 3X20 series, really just to highlight the differences in what you are going to get for that additional money. But little features like the telescoping draft links or even a drawbar, those are standard equipment that's included on this series. Okay, so next up, you have kind of an anomaly right here. Again, I call this a 3.5 series. It's a John Deere 4105. Technically, it's not in production anymore, but I happen to have one. There's a whole bunch of them in the used market. They'll be around for a long time, so I thought it was worth including. A lot of similarities though, same exact front end loaders on these tractors. You can see even the hoods, the paneling looks really similar. You're gonna see larger tires on the 4105. It's gonna be about 6 inches wider, about 5.5 foot wide compared to 5 foot wide on the 3R. But not only is it gonna have the same front end loader, but it has the same backhoe that the 3R or the 3X20 would have as well. So you can see what I mean. These larger tires, a little bit wider footprint, same tires actually as the 4R or the 4M. So it's kind of mixing little bits from the 4 and the 3 series tractors and making a pretty unique model in and of itself. So while the 3R tractor series is gonna be pretty plush and decked out with all those options, you're gonna lose a lot of those kinds of features on the 4105. In fact, you're not even gonna have a 3-range transmission. It's gonna be a 2-range, high-low hydrostatic transmission, no power reverser available, not a suspension seat, no tilt steering, no cruise control. If you're looking for a plain Jane workhorse of a tractor, the 4105 fits that bill pretty well. If I didn't mention it previously, you can put a belly mower on the 3R or the 3X20. You need to make sure it's equipped with the mid-PTO option. This is a field-addable option, one of the few series of tractors out there that you can actually add on that mid-PTO to get the belly mower. So just because you have a 3R or a 3X20 doesn't mean you're going to be able to. You may have to do something extra to outfit it that way. The 4105, on the other hand, no mid-PTO is available. Okay, so 4105, 4R series. Now this could also be the 4M series as well. There's a lot of differences in and of the 4M to the 4R, but this is the machine I have. The frame size is going to be the exact same. You have a 44 horsepower, a 52 horse, and a 66 horsepower. I wanted Chris to back up to be able to see the 3R series and kind of right on up to the 4 series, because as big of a difference as there was from the 3E to the 3R, it's that dramatic of a difference from the 3R to the 4 series as well. So while we had the 4105 here, I'm kind of going to circumvent that and talk more about the 3R versus the 4 series. You know, you have a full foot wider footprint, certainly much longer, hundreds and hundreds of pounds heavier as well. And same thing with the front end loaders, are going to lift, I think it's almost 30 or 40% more weight, and they're going to lift it a lot higher too. So when we were talking about the 3E series, and the E kind of standing for an economy sort of model, the 4M series, I don't know why it's not the 4E series, but the 4M series is that more plain Jane, economical model without a lot of bells and whistles, like your suspension seat and the tilt and the cruise. You cannot get a factory cab on a 4M series, only the 4R series. Again, I go through all of this kind of thing in a lot of detail in other videos. I'm trying to keep it brief here. But you have two versions of the loader you can get. You can also get a self-leveling loader if you want to. So as you're raising up, it's keeping your bucket or your forks parallel or in a fixed position with the ground, depending on if you're lower or higher, it doesn't change. You can get the backhoes, of course. The factory cab is fantastic. Anything you want to do with this tractor, it's very capable. It's hydrostat. You can also get that power reverser transmission if you want, but this is a true full-framed 4 series tractor compared to the tweener right here with the 4105. I really just can't say enough about this particular tractor right here. For me, I loved it so much, I sold it, you know, and I regretted it immediately and bought another one. It's just a fantastic machine. You know, if I were to build a tractor, of course, I would take features from all the different manufacturers and kind of combine them all into one, but this is about as close to perfect as it gets for me. Okay, so time for the magnet test. We're just gonna stick it right on the transaxle of all the hydrostatic transmissions that we have. You know, this is a question that comes up a lot, kind of in the 3E and the 3R conversation. These two machines are so similar in size, yet there's almost a 33% weight difference, 2,200 pounds versus 2,900 pounds without the loaders on them. So does that come from one having an aluminum rear end versus one having a steel? We're gonna find out on all of these. We'll just do a quick test here. If it sticks, it's steel. If it doesn't, it's aluminum. All right, 1025R first. Just gonna try to sneak back here and touch that rear end. Not touching at all. It wants to go find some steel. There's a lot of steel around here, but it does not want to stick at all to that transaxle. Yeah, are you chilly? We're almost done. Okay, we're almost done. Okay, next up, 2025R. Just stick it right down here. It like wants to fall off. It's not really sticking there. Just for comparison's sake, you can see attaches right to real steel here. I'm sure there's steel somewhere around here because I can feel a slight tug. It definitely does not want to stick though. Okay, next up we have the 2032R. Stick it in a couple different spots that we have access to. So you can see if there's a nut or a bolt rather, I should say, going through, it definitely wants to stick. If you find a regular piece of the transaxle, doesn't want to. Even take a look out. Ooh. Even if we move outside a little bit further, and this area here does not want to stick at all. Okay, next one up, the 3E series of tractors. Got found a little steel right there. Oh, that's just that rod going through. Let's see if we can get it to stick here. Nope. Nope. What about out here? Doesn't want to stick there. What about over here? Oh, wants to stick there, but I think it's finding some steel on the inside because it's not sticking very much. Okay, now is the one that I am really curious to know about. This is the 3520, like the 3R series tractors now. This is the one that a lot of folks online assume is steel. I don't know, I can't find either way, but we're gonna find out right now. All right, stick it around here. Oh, I found some steel there. What about out here? Nope. That's all aluminum, I guess. Oh, steel, that's bolted on. Steel, though, that's not part of the transaxle. So as far as I can tell, that's all aluminum right there. I wonder how they get all that extra weight in this machine versus the 3E. The 4105 has a backhoe and the frame and everything on it, but I can reach a small area right down here and it's not sticking either. Man alive, are all these just aluminum rear ends? Okay, so finally on the 4R series of tractors, stick it down here and see what happens. Well, look at that. And just for fun, I've got a Kubota L6060 right across the lot. Let's check that out really quick. Okay, so Kubota L6060 here, similar to the 4066R. You have steel right there. Steel there as well. Safe to say this is a steel rear end. All right, so you know, that's just a little fun test. Wanted to do it for a long time and we had all the models here, so why not? So steel versus aluminum, you know, it's just more information to have. Knowledge is power, right? Hopefully you found this to be a very informative video, give you a nice visual of all the different frame sizes that John Deere has to offer. So if you can't make it to a place that has all the models in stock or you're looking online, at least you have a visual indicator here of what the different sizes look like when they're sitting side by side. So again, if you want to get a more in-depth look at just the 4 series or the 1 versus the 2, the 3 versus the 3, I have a whole playlist of all the comparison videos that I've done. I'd encourage you to check that out. As always, if you found this helpful, I'd really love to get a thumbs up from you and hit that subscribe button right underneath the video if you haven't done so already. And make sure you read through that description below as well. All sorts of helpful links down there for tractor owners, or head on over to goodworkstractors.com. Hey, thanks so much for stopping by. Until next time, stay safe. We'll see you soon. All right, getting dark. Let's put these bad boys away.